Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And today we are going to read a very important topic from examination point of view, that are specialized connective tissue. In the very last lecture, we have talked about the basics of connective tissue as well as the two main types of connective tissue, that are loose connective tissues and dense connective tissues. I made a playlist on my channel जहाँ पर आपको epithelial tissue, connective tissue, neural tissue और muscular tissues के सारे lecture मिल जाएंगे in a proper sequence, so you can check it out. So today's topic is specialized connective tissue. Okay, loose connective tissue के बारे में हम बात कर चुके हैं, that in that particular connective tissue the fiber bundles and the collagen fibers are loosely arranged or loosely packed. So जो fibers हैं वो काफी दूर दूर present होंगे. And in dense connective tissue the fibers are present very nearby, so there is a good interaction between different kind of fibers. वो आसपास present होंगे और इसीलिए उनकी strength या फिर उनकी density जो थी ज़्यादा थी और इसीलिए उनका नाम था dense connective tissue. Now the third category is specialized connective tissue. These are some sort of special cells or special tissues. तो इनमें कौन-कौन सी चीजें आती हैं? सबसे पहले तो ये काफी ज़्यादा abundant होते हैं. How can we learn that specialized connective tissue are very abundant? क्योंकि इनके example हैं cartilage, okay, bones and blood. सबसे ज़्यादा abundant जो fluid है हमारी body में, that is blood, okay, 5 to 7 liters होता है, तो काफी ज़्यादा इसकी volume है. और जो mass है हमारी पूरी body का, जो most of the mass है, वो होता है in bones, right? In bones and cartilage. तो obviously हमारी body का major part बनाते हैं, since these are making major part of our body. If you will talk about fluid connective tissue, तो blood is the major tissue. And if you will talk about solid connective tissue, then bones and cartilage are major tissues. ये body का mostly weight बनाते हैं, इसीलिए ये बहुत ही ज़्यादा abundant होते हैं in our body as compared to epithelial tissue, neural tissue या muscular tissue. उनके comparison में काफी ज़्यादा abundant होता है connective tissue. Okay? So now let's talk about the properties of different examples of specialized connective tissue. ये काफी types के हो सकते हैं. For example, blood हो सकता है, bones हो सकती हैं and cartilage हो सकती हैं. ये तीन main specialized connective tissues हैं. सबसे पहले बात करेंगे about blood. We know very well about blood that this is fluid connective tissue. We know very well about blood that it is fluid in nature, right? This is a liquid. So this is fluid connective tissue. And one most important point that we have already talked about in last lecture, that blood is not containing any kind of fibers. हमने बात की थी connective tissue के जो cells हैं, वो क्या बना रहे थे? Modified polysaccharides, that is the ground substance, and they are forming different kind of fibers which are collagen and elastin. But these fibers are not present in blood. So this is an exception. This is the connective tissue that is devoid of fibers, or this is the only connective tissue that is not having any kind of fibers. Okay, so blood will not have any kind of fibers. It have different kind of cells, जो कि हम बचपन से पढ़ते हुए आ रहे हैं. That is, it will have WBC, यानी कि इसमें होंगे white blood cells. It will have platelets that will help in blood clotting. It will look like this. The platelet will look like this, right? And it helps in the clotting of blood. जब कहीं पे cut लग जाता है body पे, so there is clotting mechanism, right? That particular clotting mechanism is very much helpful in bone healing, and that is mainly due to platelets. There are another kind of cells also. There is a matrix that is usually known as plasma. There is mostly plasma in case of blood, and there are RBCs, which are red blood cells. These are biconcave disc-like shape. This is the shape of RBC. Okay. One most important thing about this is hemoglobin. We know about hemoglobin, right? It provides the blood its color. The blood is red due to the presence of hemoglobin pigment, and it contains iron as central metal. Okay, so there is iron, and there are four chains in case of hemoglobin. Four chains होती हैं. दो का नाम होता है alpha chain, दो का नाम होता है beta chain. Okay. So there are four chains. Let us consider that this is alpha, alpha, then beta and beta. So if this is a beta chain, तो इस beta chain की sixth position पर mutation हो जाती है. ये हम पढ़ेंगे in the genetics. ये हम genetics में पढ़ते हैं mostly about mutations, that बीटा ग्लोबिन चेन के ऊपर सिक्स्थ पोजीशन पे देयर इज सम काइंड ऑफ म्यूटेशन, द ग्लूटामिक एसिड गॉट रिप्लेस्ड बाय वैलाइन, तो ग्लूटामिक एसिड की जगह वैलाइन आ जाता है ऑन द सिक्स्थ पोजीशन ऑफ बीटा ग्लोबिन चेन व्हिच कॉजेस सम चेंजेस इन द शेप ऑफ आरबीसी. दिस इज बाय कॉनकेव डिस्क लाइक शेप बट ड्यू टू म्यूटेशन इट बिकम्स सिकल शेप लाइक दिस. And this is very narrow. Like we know very well about the shape of sickle that it is a little bit narrow. So, iski wajah se kya hota hai? There is decrease in the area. So, the oxygen carrying capacity of a particular cell decreases. Okay? So, koi bhi jo blood hai, uski oxygen carry karne ki capacity kam ho jayegi. Aur is bimari ko hum kehte hain sickle cell anemia. Kyunki isme RBC jo hai, wo sickle shape ho jati hai. And anemia simply means the loss of oxygen. Or we can say that the decrease in amount of oxygen. Since the volume of RBC is getting lower, that's why the oxygen carrying capacity of RBC is also decreased. That's why anemia. इसीलिए इस बीमारी को आ जाता है सिकल सेल अनेमिया, जिसमें sixth position of beta globin chain get altered by mutation. Okay? और blood की जो main functions है वो हम सबको पता है, that it helps in the exchange of gases. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड चाहे बाहर भेजनी हो, ऑक्सीजन अंदर लेनी हो, ऑल दिस प्रोसीजर, ऑल दिस एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस इज डन बाय ब्लड. द यू नो पासिंग ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स, ओके, और जो ब्लड जैसे कि प्लेसेंटा में न्यूट्रिएंट्स सप्लाई करता है, ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स टेक्स प्लेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्लड. ओके, एंड द रिमूवल ऑफ वेस्ट ऑल्सो टेक्स प्लेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्लड, एज वेल एज द ट्रांसफर ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ हॉर्मोन्स फॉर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एक्शंस also take place with the help of blood. So blood have different kind of functions, right? It is the fluid connective tissue which do not have fibers. It have different kind of cells such as WBC, RBC, platelets, plasma. It has hemoglobin and all other cells. Unke saath saath isme ek bimari ho sakti hai, that is sickle cell anemia due to the mutation on sixth position of beta globin chain of hemoglobin. Iski wajah se disease bhi ho sakti hai. Aur यहाँ पर क्या क्या हो सकता है, ये हेल्प करता है इन द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ गैसेस, ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस, इट हेल्प इन द रिमूवल ऑफ वेस्ट, इट हेल्प इन टेकिंग ऑफ फूड, एंड इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन द यू नो पैसेज ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ हॉर्मोन्स, क्योंकि नॉट ऑल हॉर्मोन्स आर सिंथेसाइज्ड एट द प्लेस ऑफ एक्शन. सारे हॉर्मोन्स एक जगह पे सिंथेसाइज नहीं होते जहां पे उनका एक्शन होता है, काफी हॉर्मोन्स को ट्रेवल भी करना पड़ता है, एंड दैट ट्रेवलिंग is done with the help of blood. Blood used to supply that particular hormone at the place where it is needed from the place where it is synthesized. Okay? So, uski jo transfer hai, pura mechanism jo hai, wo blood ke through hota hai. Now, the second type of specialized connective tissue is bone. Okay? We know very well about bone that it is very hard. Kyunki bones are not easily breaked. They are unbreakable. Itni aasani se nahi tootti, to obviously they are going to be hard. As well as non-pliable. What is non-pliable? They cannot be, you know, bent easily. So these are non-pliable. Just opposite to that, this cartilage is solid but pliable. The cartilage is a little bit pliable. Lekin bone ko hum sabko bataya ki bone ko hum itni aasani se bend nahi kar sakte. So bone is non-pliable, but cartilage is a little bit pliable. It has some sort of flexibility, right? But bone is not that much flexible. It has a lot of collagen fibers which provides it more strength, as well as there are some calcium salts such as calcium carbonate and calcium phosphate which provides it much strength, due to which it becomes more or less unbreakable, right? It has a lot of strength or a lot of strong bondings between that. Okay, to isi wajah se zyada aasani se bones tootti nahi hai. So the bones are hard, non-pliable, since they cannot be bent easily. They have calcium salts. We know very well about that. Ki bones calcium salt ki banti hai. Calcium carbonate, calcium phosphate are the main constituents of calcium salt which make bone as well as teeth, right? And there are a lot of collagen fiber, we have talked about it, which provides the bone more strength. Okay? And now we know about the 206 bones in case of human beings. All these bones are formed up of calcium salts, as well as it have a lot of collagen fiber, and those 206 bones provide us the whole framework, right? हमारी body का जितना भी frame है, वो सारा का सारा किससे बना हुआ है? हड्डियों से बना हुआ है. those bones will provide us a proper stature, a proper framework, और उसी framework पे सारी की सारी चीजें attach होती हैं. The ligaments are attached here, the skeletal muscles are attached here. उसके बाद it gives protection to different kind of organs. और वो organs भी attached होते हैं to skeletal system, which provide us a pure shape. Okay? So the skeletal system also provide us with support. Okay? This is the supportive system of our body. As well as it protect different kind of organs. Because जो इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स हैं उनके ऊपर एक प्रोटेक्टिव शील्ड की तरह काम करते हैं स्केलेटल बोन्स. ओके, सो बोन्स इज फॉर्मिंग अ सपोर्टिव फ्रेमवर्क एज वेल एज इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग प्रोटेक्शन टू डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स फ्रॉम इंजरी. ओके, सो देयर आर सम सेल्स इन दैट टिश्यू. ऑब्वियसली बोन इज अ काइंड ऑफ स्पेशलाइज्ड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू एंड दैट टिश्यू इज फॉर्मड अप ऑफ सेल्स. Those specialized cells are known as osteocytes. Okay, osteo simply means bone and site simply means cells. So bone cells are known as osteocytes. In case of cartilage, the cells are known as chondrocytes. Chondro simply means cartilage and site simply means cells. Okay, so this is quite relative to the name itself. Osteocyte simply means bone cells and chondrocyte simply means cartilage cells. So osteocytes होते हैं वो cavities में present होते हैं. Okay, there is a cavity inside the tissue and inside that cavity, उस cavity के बीच में present होता है osteocyte, that are bone cells. So the bone cells are present in a cavity and that cavity is known as lacunae. Okay, this is very important from examination point of view. This question is asked many times कि what is the name of cavity inside which osteo साइड सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट, राइट? ऑस्टियोसाइट सेल्स. ऑस्टियोसाइट सेल आर द बोन सेल्स. ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट विल बी द सेल्स विच आर फॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ बोन्स, राइट? तो ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट, जैसे हमने बात की थी लास्ट लेक्चर में, फाइब्रोब्लास्ट द सेल विच इज फॉर्मिंग फाइबर्स. सिंपली ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट सेल विल फॉर्म ऑस्टियोसाइट्स एंड कॉन्ड्रोब्लास्ट सेल विल फॉर्म कॉन्ड्रोसाइट्स. ओके, ब्लास्ट का मतलब होता है फॉर्मेशन. So fibroblast will make fibers, osteoblast will make osteocytes and chondroblast will make chondrocytes. There is nothing new in that. So these osteocytes are present within cavity and those cavities are known as lacunae. For example, this central portion is osteocyte, that is bone cell, and it is present in a cavity. This particular thing is a cavity. This is also a cavity. This is also a cavity. These cavities are known as lacunae and this is very important. Okay, so the osteocytes are present in a cavity that is known as lacunae. और यहाँ पर बात हो रही है एक सेल की. And since we know that bone is a specialized connective tissue and tissue is formed up of many cells, so there are many cavities and these cavities are having many osteocytes. Okay, after that the weight bearing function is taken by bones. आपको पता है कि आपका लिम्बिक सिस्टम जो है काफी ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है, आपके लेग्स काफी ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है, आपके हैंड काफी ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है एंड योर लेग्स कैरी होल ऑफ योर बॉडी वेट. आपकी बॉडी का जितना भी वेट है वो सारे के सारे आपके लेग्स कैरी करते हैं. सो जो आपकी बॉडी का वेट बियरिंग फंक्शन है दैट इज ऑल्सो यू नो टेकन अप बाय बोन्स बिकॉज बोन कैरी ऑल ऑफ योर वेट. सो द वेट बियरिंग फंक्शन इज ऑल्सो टेकन अप बाय बोन एज वेल एज with the help of some kind of muscles, some kind of ligaments, it also helps in locomotion. हम लोग चल पाते हैं तो वो सब हमारी skeletal system की वजह से ही है. There are some sort of skeletal muscles and there are some sort of skeletal bones और वो एक combination में काम करते हैं which makes us move in a very specific manner. एक particular direction में हमें जाने में मदद करते हैं, हम जहां पर चलना चाहते हैं वहां पर हमें पहुंचा देते हैं. That is known as locomotion, which is you know done with the help of skeletal bones and skeletal muscles as well as some specialized bones. Not all bones but some bones carry some cells that are marrow, bone marrow. So some bones will have bone marrow in them and that bone marrow has a function to synthesize different kind of blood cells. Okay, and the formation of blood cells is known as hemopoiesis. Okay, that this is asked many times in examination about hemopoiesis. Okay, so the function of hemopoiesis is taken care by bone marrow, or bone marrow present hoti hai kafi sari bones mein, not in all bones but in many bones bone marrow is present, which have a specific function to make different kind of blood cells. Okay, so these are osteocytes which are present in cavity that are known as lacunae, and this is about bone. Now let's talk about cartilage. Cartilage is obviously solid, okay, and it is pliable, unlike that of bone. Bone is non-pliable because it cannot be bent properly, right? But this is a little bit pliable. This is solid in nature, lekin ye pliable bhi hoga. It resists compression. It resists compression. It simply means that it is having strength, right? It resists any kind of compression in that. So isme kya hogi? Strength bhi kafi zyada hogi. It is pliable. It means that it is flexible. Lekin aisa nahi hai ki pliable hone ki wajah se iski strength kam ho jayegi. Isme strength bhi kafi zyada rahegi. So it has a lot of strength as well as it is solid and pliable in nature. That's why the three major properties of cartilage is it is solid, it is pliable, as well as it resists compression. It simply means that it is having a lot of strength in it. It also has some kind of cells. Since that cartilage is also a kind of tissue, and tissue is formed about different kind of cells, right? Many cells. So those cells are known as chondrocytes. Chondro simply means cartilage, site simply means cell. Aur yahan par bhi osteocytes ki tarah, these are also present in some kind of cavities inside the matrix that is secreted by the chondrocyte itself. Humne baat ki thi connective tissue ke basics mein ki the cells synthesize modified polysaccharides and fibers. So the fibers and modified polysaccharide, that is the ground substance, both are secreted by the cells themselves. इसी तरीके से कॉन्ड्रोसाइट भी खुद ही मैट्रिक्स बनाता है एंड खुद ही फाइबर सिंथेसाइज करता है. सो द कैविटी एंड द मैट्रिक्स इन विच इट इज प्रेजेंट, द कॉन्ड्रोसाइट इज प्रेजेंट इन अ कैविटी इनसाइड द मैट्रिक्स क्रिएटेड बाय द कॉन्ड्रोसाइट इटसेल्फ. ओके, सो द कॉन्ड्रोसाइट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ मैट्रिक्स एज वेल एज इट्स कैविटी, इट्स सराउंडिंग मीडियम. ओके, सो इट इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन कैविटी. जैसे जैसे हम बड़े होते जाते हैं, when we grow adult, तो क्या होता है, most of the cartilage are getting converted into bones, right? तो cartilage क्या होती है, bones में convert हो जाती है और उसके बाद cartilage बनना बंद हो जाती है. लेकिन क्या होता है, काफी जगह पे cartilage बनती रहती है और वहीं पर present होती है. For example, there are some examples of cartilage. For example, tip of nose, here we can touch it, it is cartilage. Okay, the end joining of ear and the adjacent bones of vertebral column in case of adult are joined with the help of cartilage. Okay, as well as in limbs, as well as in hands, काफी सारी cartilage present होती हैं. So these are the main examples of cartilage. What are the main examples of cartilage? You can view most of them, right? You can easily understand that cartilage is obviously being present on limbs, that is hand and leg. So there will be no confusion कि हाथ और पैर में तो होगी. बाकी आप लोग देख सकते हो नोज की टिप एंड ईयर. एक एग्जांपल बचता है, दैट इज द एडजेसेंट बोन ऑफ वर्टिब्रल कॉलम. सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड जस्ट सिंगल एग्जांपल, दैट इज वर्टिब्रल कॉलम. अगर ये एग्जांपल याद हो गया तो बाकी सारे हो सकते हैं, क्योंकि बाकी कार्टिलेज तो ऑब्वियसली आपको पता ही है, हाथ में होगी, दैट इज इन हैंड्स, इन लेग्स, नोज पे और ईयर पे आपको दिख ही जाएगी. सो द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज on the adjacent bone of vertebral column in case of adults is also having cartilage, which is very important example. So you have to memorize it. This may be asked in examination. This is about specialized connective tissues. So let's take an overview ki humne aaj kya kya padha. Firstly, the specialized connective tissue are much different than loose connective tissue and dense connective tissue. It has three major examples: blood, bone and cartilage. The blood is fluid connective tissue which is devoid of fibers, that is it is not containing any kind of fibers. It is having different kind of cells such as WBC, RBC, platelets, plasma, hemoglobin, etc. Okay, it has some functions to carry different things, to transfer gases, to transfer nutrients, to transfer excreta, as well as to transfer hormones from one place to another. Okay, now it comes to bone. बोन प्रेजेंट होंगे एक कैविटी में, दैट पर्टिकुलर कैविटी इज नोन एज लैकुने, और लैकुने के बीच में द बोन सेल विच इज प्रेजेंट इज नोन एज ऑस्टियोसाइट. ऑस्टियो सिंपली मीन्स बोन, साइट सिंपली मीन्स सेल. ओके, सो दिस इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द लैकुने. एंड सिंस बोन प्रोवाइड अ लॉट ऑफ फंक्शन, इट प्रोवाइड्स स्ट्रक्चरल फ्रेमवर्क, इट प्रोवाइड्स प्रोटेक्शन टू द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स. The weight bearing function is also carried out by bones, as well as different kind of functions such as locomotion, as well as in some bones bone marrow is present, which is responsible for the synthesis of different kind of blood cells, which is usually known as hemolysis. Okay, now it comes to cartilage, which is solid and pliable. It is solid, pliable, as well as it resists compression, that is it is having a lot of strength. Okay, iske baad most of the cartilage are converted into bones except a few, और वो जो है main example है cartilage के, that are the tip of nose and joining of ears, hands, leg, and the most important one between the adjacent bones of vertebral column in case of adults. These are the important examples of cartilage, and this is all about specialized connective tissue. I hope कि आपको ये lecture पसंद आया होगा. अगर आपको ये lecture पसंद आया then please do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, then please do hit subscribe button and share this video among your friends and tell them to subscribe my channel too. Thank you so much again for watching this video and stay tuned for the upcoming video, guys.